Good afternoon, good evening, no matter where you're coming from. Hope you all are doing well. We're going to learn the basics of Git and GitHub from an actual beginner standpoint. I feel like there's a lot of stuff out there when it comes to Git and GitHub that if it's your first time dabbling in it, it can be really overwhelming, cause a lot of stress. But we're going to show how Git can be a tool that you can use every single day. My name is Leon. I am the managing director of engineering for a nonprofit called Resilient Coders. It's my job to help folks get jobs as software engineers and help them get the skills that they need to become software engineers. I want you to learn how to learn. And so we're going to start off this stream, not with Git, not with the terminal, not with GitHub, but with learning how to learn. It's something that's changed my life. That's changed the lives of a lot of my students. If you only listen to two things I say tonight, one, make sure you have a GitHub account, and then two, make sure you learn how to learn. Then we're going to break down what the heck is this terminal thing. We are going to learn the basics of Git, and then we're going to show how to use GitHub along with Git to do some really cool stuff. Now, before we jump into Git, we have to start with something called the terminal. Whenever you hear the word terminal, I don't want it to cause fear or panic. Whenever you hear the word terminal, all I want you to think of is a place where you can type commands that cause action. But just a place where we can type stuff and things happen. That's it. So way back in the day, if you bought an Apple II, what it gave you was access to a command line or a CLI, a command line interface. And so you turned on this Apple II computer, and instead of getting a GUI, or a graphical user interface, you got a command line interface. And there was no internet to figure stuff out. No GUI, no folders, no anything. From the command line interface, you could run commands, you could run utilities, and you could still do some pretty cool stuff. It was just a very different experience. And so this command line interface, or eventually we'll call it the terminals where we access this command line interface, it's still alive well today. We can look at a terminal that I have on my machine right here in this bottom right-hand corner. This is my terminal. I'm gonna walk you through some common commands, and then I'm gonna show you kind of how to get this working on your own machine. If you're on Windows, I recommend Git Bash for this evening. If you're on macOS or GNU Linux, you probably already have a program called Terminal that you could open up and that you could follow along with us. So let's talk about some common commands. Right now, you can see that I'm in my class 24 folder. And so there is a really common command that you can use called pwd. And so I'm just gonna type pwd, and this stands for print working directory. And the cool thing is it can show you the full path to the folder that I am currently in. Now, once I am in a folder, I can even do things like make folders wherever I am at. Keep your eye up here in my GUI, and I'm gonna type in make dir example, as I have made a new directory or a new folder called example. Some other commands that you're gonna see a lot are cd or change directory. So if I wanna go into the example folder that I just created, I could do cd space and then example, and I could type it all the way out, or I can even just hit tab. I'm right now inside of example. If I wanted to go up a level back to class 24, I could do CD dot dot. And now I am back in the class 24 folder. CD tilde specifically, what it's gonna do is bring me all the way back to the beginning, all the way back to my home folder. And then if I wanted to get back to where I was into that class 24 folder, I'm going to have to CD into it. So I could CD desktop, and then I'd be on the desktop. I wanna create an HTML file inside of that example folder. Okay, so change directory into my example folder. CD, so here I'm gonna do touch index.html, and as soon as I hit enter, you can see that this HTML file was created. I didn't have to open up VS Code. I didn't have to create a new file. I didn't have to save. I could just do touch index.html, and boom, we have an HTML file. All right, and I'm gonna try my best to kind of explain like why Git is really useful, why as software engineers, we're gonna use it all the time. So Git solves some very important problems for us. And Git solves this problem not for your Word docs or your essays, but for your code. Git gives you the ability, right? It gives you the ability to make save points. And all a version control system is like a really fancy term for tracking changes. It enables you to take what we call snapshots. These snapshots you make by making a commit. Commit is just a fancy term for creating a save point. Git, one of the most beautiful things, is that once you make a snapshot, you can roll back to a previous snapshot. So let's say you are writing your code and you get lost in the sauce and you're like, this is horrendous. I should have never, ever done this. Instead of having to do command Z, 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 we could just roll back to one of our snapshots. There are many ways to install Git. If you're on Windows, I recommend Git for Windows for today. And then if you're on Mac OS, I really love Homebrew. So what you would do is you would take this link here and you would grab it and you would paste it into your terminal over here. Once you do have it installed, there's two commands that you almost, you always want to run these commands before you do anything else. These will set your global username for Git and your global email for Git. And whatever email you use, it should be the email that you use for GitHub just to make your life easier. Alrighty, let's talk about some basic Git commands. And then as you kind of get more into Git, you'll learn a little bit more and a little bit more of the flag. So with Git init, we can create a special folder that we can store all of our snapshots in. We are initializing a Git repository. So I'm gonna do Git init. And you can see I created an empty Git repository, a place where I can store those snapshots. So once we have this repository where we can store our snapshots, we're gonna wanna gather all the files that are gonna make up the snapshot. Git add enables us to kind of grab all the stuff. Eventually, we can use a special command to take the snapshot that saves all that stuff into the repository. I could add an individual file. So I could do something like git add index.html. And if I just wanted to add everything to my staging area, I could just do git add dot. It's on the stage. It's in the staging area, right? And when I am ready, I can take a snapshot of everything that's on the stage and put it in that special folder. The special word that we use to take the snapshot of everything that's in staging is called commit. I can do git status, and git status shows me all the stuff that is waiting to be saved, that's waiting to be part of that snapshot. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do git commit. So now when I hit enter, you can see all of my history has now been saved as a snapshot, and that's now in my repository until I get rid of it. There's one other thing that I wanna do, and that's eventually I wanna get to branches. What if you wanna try something without borking all your code? Git actually gives us this really wonderful feature that we don't have to rely on just rolling back. We can actually kind of create branches from our main code. I'm gonna go ahead and clear here, and I'm gonna do a git status. So we can see that I am on main. What I can do is I can create a new branch where I make all my like risky stuff happen. And then I have to check out that branch. And if I do a git status, you can see that I am on branch risky. I wanna go ahead and make some changes. I wanna create a risky file. I, however, don't like the path that I've gone down. I wanted to go back to my original set of code. If I do a git checkout main, what just happened? Did you see it? We switched the main and risky's no longer there. You can now write code risk-free. I want to show you one really cool thing, and that cool thing is GitHub. We have all these save points. GitHub enables us to take our snapshots and put them in the cloud. But we also get a whole suite of tools that make it easier to work with developers. If you don't already have a GitHub account, make one after class so that way you can push up the code that we did today. Thank you, Microsoft Azure, for sponsoring this class, for helping us unlock the power of Git and GitHub, for helping us entry-level engineers get free places to host our code. That's the whole kit and caboodle.